a horse and buggy in intercourse.
What you're about to watch is possibly the first ever attempt of its kind to document a religion that rejects modern technology, adopted by people living just outside some of the most technologically advanced cities in the world. This is a group known as the Amish. The Amish are a group of traditionalist Christian church fellowships with Swiss and German roots dating back over 300 years. And as you can probably tell, they stand out from most other cultures for their voluntary neglect of technology, including no driving motor vehicles, and preferring instead to a horse and buggy. Eric and I, who have been joining in on more of the Yes Theory adventures, decided to create one of our own. Having grown up just outside of New York City, we've been curious about the Amish our whole lives. We've always found it so fascinating that in this day and age, hundreds of thousands of people voluntarily choose to live without technology. So, our mission will be to see if we can convince an Amish family to take us into their homes for a few days and actually allow us to document their lives. Now, there's a reason this has never been done before. The Amish community hates cameras, as taking pictures is actually not allowed in their religion. Videos, however, are allowed, but the Amish are extremely reluctant to be on camera, since past videos about them have caused them a great deal of misrepresentation. The only shows made about the Amish are from the perspective of people who have left the community, or reality shows that portray them as trapped and unaware of the thrilling world outside of their hometown. The hope is that we, with our genuine curiosity about the Amish people, are able to be adopted by a family that will show us the true Amish experience.
You guys are about to experience such an insane contrast from like New York City
with all of this to the Amish.
Holy shit. Nothing.
You're sending the youngins to try and
Exactly. Yes. The next generation of Yes Theory. Let's go.
How are we gonna text you if we don't have technology?
Oh. I have pigeons.
Yeah.
Currently on the way to Intercourse, which is we're on the way to Intercourse, which is an Amish town. We decided to have Eric's mom join us.
Yeah, we think maybe it'll be more helpful than this, like just two weird-looking boys.
You're just gonna go to a random Amish and say we want you to adopt us for the night?
Yeah.
Interesting.
The two dumbest guys of Yes Theory going to see the Amish.
Two dumb guys. That should be our show. Welcome to
Two Dumb Guys.
Intercourse, Pennsylvania.
Hello.
Hi. That literally looked like she was from a different era.
This is so much crazier than I thought it would be.
We literally crossed like a invisible border. Now we're back like in the 1700s.
Should we just follow him? We're faster than him, that's for sure. We got 100 horsepower, you got one horse.
sir, excuse me.
This is the worst start ever.
Excuse me, sir.
We're trying to see if there's any way for us to meet an Amish family or spend some time on a farm.
We do have a ride here. We do a farm tour.
Yeah.
Still okay.
Yeah. Thank you. Appreciate it, man.
Thank you very much.
We're trying to find an Amish family that would actually let him stay with them.
I don't know if there would be someone in the area that would do that or not.
We came here to see if there was anyone who would take us in and let us kind of try and experience your life.
You're going to have to ask somebody else.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a dad. You want to ask him and I'll hold the GoPro?
Fuck.
Go for it.
Hey, how's it going? How are you?
Good.
Would you know a family or your family that would potentially be okay with us being around?
And help out and just... Thank you so much, man.
Thank you very much for your time.
Have a good one.
Have a great day.
Damn. Why did I think this was going to be easy?
I'm realizing this is extremely difficult. Potentially not even humanly possible because I don't think anyone's ever done this.
We just got to find like a super chill Amish family. Just down for anything.
Does that even exist? Anyone who works on a farm here would take us in for 24 hours and let us volunteer on the farm and kind of live with them and experience. I know, it's a pretty crazy ask, but we're just driving around and seeing if anyone would want some help and to show us kind of their lifestyle.
Yeah, well, I just live here with my parents.
So oh, yeah?
They're still at the boss. I'm pretty sure you can come and check out the farm.
Great, we'll drive in. Thank you, man.
Wow, this guy is so nice.
My name's Caleb.
You're so friendly.
Oh, sorry.
Got it.
Yeah, come in. Yeah. Cool. Are you filming? Sick.
He like appreciates what we're doing. He was like, I like that you guys are curious about
our lifestyle.
See if we can stay here.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't have much time. I got a softball game tonight.
No way.
We'll come cheer you on.
Yeah, yeah. That'd be great.
Is this a cell phone?
Yeah.
How do you charge it? Electricity. Yeah. So electricity is okay?
Yeah, it's not quite what you hear.
Does everyone follow like their own rules around it, or is there like a set in stone thing of what you guys all follow?
No, it's not a set in stone. Yeah. Pretty free.
Yeah, I love it.
Wow.
This is awesome.
Very nice.
Oh, wow.
Washing machine. It's normal living.
These people are from Los Angeles. They're looking for an experience.
Okay. You're not looking for commercialism. You're looking for the real.
Exactly.
Walking.
Finally. Oh, yeah, by the way, my name's Eric.
Oh, okay.
This is Tommy.
She's sore on her feet. We were out to Tijuana, Mexico to see a doctor.
Yeah.
So we had the first experience of flying back and forth.
Wow.
But before that, I spent like 40 years here on the farm. And I've never traveled. I can see my mailbox most of the time.
Wow, how was the flying experience?
Awesome.
I'd like to ask you a question.
Yes.
What does that seek discomfort mean? I thought it's like you're getting out. And,
that's exactly right. Yeah. It's our motto.
I thought maybe,
of.
Yeah.
Like
seek discomfort.
Get out of the comfort zone.
Right? Exactly. Yeah.
Step out.
Yeah, out to Los Angeles.
Yeah.
I am so down to do that.
Would you actually come to Los Angeles?
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, yes.
Samuel, would you allow these two guys to stay here for the night?
Where are you going to sleep?
Wherever.
Here.
We'll sleep on the floor.
On a couch on the floor in the barn with the cows.
In the balcony.
That
stinks, I know, but...
So what?
Read our language.
We can't just give him the best of everything,
exactly.
Because they're here to really see our culture, not,
that's right.
Not the polished side of it.
Dad needs to get mom's input on this.
That's right.
So yeah.
He's not the only one living here.
Understood.
We'll visit again this evening sometime.
Perfect.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you so much.
I can't believe what's happening. We did it.
This is crazy.
We're going to his softball game, and we're going to drive him. So, like, as long as he doesn't drive, he's allowed to drive in somebody else's car. Usually he takes his horse, but we offered to drive him.
I already feel like we're a part of the family.
I like people that are in for a new experience because I like that myself, and I know how it feels, and I like to feel at home with people, so, yeah, I try to make people feel the same, so.
We dropped Elam off at his game, went to go get dinner, and came back 4 hours later to find him still playing softball.
Still playing?
They're still playing.
There's a horse parked here.
So while the guys play softball, all their horses just kind of stand here. They have like parking spots for their horses.
How's the game?
They're playing really well. Getting this.
Elam's team lost.
There's like literally no frustration.
It's like the best sportsmanship I've ever seen.
One of them said with a smile on their face, "Ah, that was a bummer." That's it.
Oh, then they're off. See ya.
You played well, son.
Yeah, it was a blast.
Really proud of you.
Just get out and have some fun.
Man, that's crazy. You guys played for like 6 hours.
You guys usually play that long?
Pretty much, yeah.
Wow. Whoa.
What?
That's actually so cool.
Yeah. That's pretty Amish, right?
Maybe you'd like run us through like what a normal day in your life looks like.
So I get up in the morning like 5:30-ish. You know, you never know what the day is going to bring. Just get up and be ready to do whatever it takes.
Would you describe yourself as just a pretty happy guy?
For the most part, I really have a lot to be thankful for. I feel happy. I might not always look that way.
You've looked super happy to us.
You've looked really happy.
You know, I have people telling me how I should live. And I'm like, yeah, you can tell me all you want. It's still my life. I'm going to live it. Get out and see how people live and enjoy it.
That's pretty cool.
Wait, so you said you watch YouTube.
I do.
What's your favorite thing to watch on YouTube?
A lot of stuff. Sports, I love watching. Oh, I love that. Number one would be farming. I love watching that.
They interesting.
Really?
Big equipment.
Oh, I was wondering, do you have any extra like working clothes if we do something tomorrow? If you
I got
mind.
Plenty of shirts up in the room. You can help
That'd
yourself.
Be amazing.
Yes, yeah, I even have extra suspenders.
Yeah. Amazing, thank you.
Oh, wow.
Somebody can have that. It's going to be happy.
It's going to be awesome.
You're the best, man.
Thank you.
What's up, Johnny?
We're here to work.
We're here to help.
What's the easiest job?
Push the feet in for the cows.
Push the feet in for the cows?
Brooms. Do you know what brooms are?
Yeah, yeah. Great.
Amazing.
Because do you know what brooms are? I do look pretty useless.
There you go, Bessie.
So much.
A lot of milk.
While working, we were chatting to Elam's brother about our drone, and they seemed pretty eager to see it for themselves.
So funny, you guys want to try the drone and we want to try getting in a horse buggy.
It's pretty good at flying.
Yeah.
They're legit better at flying drones than I am.
I like stuff like that.
You're really good at it.
We've only been up for 2 hours and we're exhausted.
So our plan for the day is, it's Samuel's birthday, who's the dad who let us stay here. So we're gonna go get him a birthday cake.
We're gonna go to Target.
What, Target?
Started. Zombie on the track. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now my whole team in. Started from the bottom, now we here. Started from the bottom, now the whole team. Yeah, I done kept it real from the jump. Living at my mama's house, we'd argue every month. I was trying to get it on my own. Working all night, traffic on the way.
Happy birthday.
We got some cake.
We got some donuts.
Yeah.
Yeah. Happy birthday to you. Yeah.
What's your favorite thing about the community? What is it that people don't know?
One of our strong points is supporting each other, working together for the good of your neighbor. People were concerned about what can I do for my neighbor? He had a hardship. So we go rebuild his barn, or we help him with his hospital costs or something.
Does that happen often?
It does.
That's awesome.
It's really an awesome birthday.
Yay!
Remember that.
Oh, that means a lot. It means a lot.
Evan Eric can come here.
That bluebird in your heart.
What does that mean?
It can mean a lot of different things. To me, it's, I'm not carrying any grudges, I'm not carrying any resentment, I'm not prejudiced, there's no hate. It's just all happy and good. I just think that's a bad choice to carry resentment, because bitterness, it'll destroy the vessel in which it's carried. It'll eat through.
Like, how did you get good at forgiveness?
Because I think it's something we take for granted. I think we were taught that from day one. Family carriage.
Wow.
So,
the
next
step.
Wow. You ever had a buggy ride?
Never. No.
See
you,
Mom.
Yeah.
Bye, Mom.
Whoa.
Careful, these two dumb guys may be flying down the road.
Two dumb guys. Really fast.
Oh, my God.
It just drifted. This is like Fast and Furious.
I feel fully Amish. Can you go drive?
Can you trust me?
Yeah. Come on, Sonny.
Give the left line a bit of a jerk and say, come on, Bessie.
Come on, Bessie.
Wow. Oh, my God. How are you doing this?
My dreams are coming true. Thank you, man.
I'm controlling the horse.
I want to drive Uber, but like with this.
What a day.
How do we run into the coolest Amish person? Like, this isn't the full Amish experience.
I don't know what is.
We stayed with Samuel and his family for another 2 days and got to dive deeper into life as Amishmen. But what stuck out to both of us was just how inclusive and supportive they are of the special needs community. Way more than we've seen in our society.
We're about to say our goodbyes to Sam and the family. Ah, this is sad, Sam. This is sad.
Yeah, well, you'll be back. We will be back.
I can't wait to be back, actually.
Yes.
Yep.
He's got a...
Thank you, Tommy.
Thank you for coming. You're like Amish dad.
We're appreciated.
We appreciate you.
Boys. Yeah, it's gonna be different once you guys leave. Hopefully you enjoyed it.
Oh, we had an amazing time. Hopefully we weren't bugging you too much.
Oh no, that was fun.
All right, thank you, man.
Yeah,
thank you for
everything. Thank you,
dude.
God bless y'all.
God bless you too.
Wanted some Seek Discomfort clothing, so we have this one Seek Discomfort sweater.
I gave him the yellow one too.
Awesome.
I love it.
Yeah.
Enjoy the Seek Discomfort.
Yeah.
I will. I'll make that my motto.
Yes.
Yes.
Keep saying yes, dude.
Yep.
See ya.
Come on.
Yeah, see ya. Bye-bye.
While I may not sell my car and start riding in a horse and buggy, although that would be pretty fun, there's a lot of the Amish culture that I would like to implement into my own life. At the beginning of the journey, like many, I thought the Amish people's lives were restricted, stuck in the past, rejecting technology that can make their lives easier. But I quickly learned that their rules weren't as strict as I'd imagined, and that more than simply rejecting most technology, they're actually just happier without it. In a society where we often are craving more, more, and more, the Amish remain grateful for all the things they already have.
I really have a lot to be thankful for.
Elam's family took us in, gave us food, shelter, and literally the clothes off their backs to make us feel welcome. And after spending time as an Amish person, I was reminded what matters so much more than the material possessions we think we need. Yeah. It's being grateful for our families and the community we keep around us.
Two dumb guys.
Two dumb guys.